Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Last week, I released a video on how to make human models work with the Mixamo animations in HitFilm. And somebody asked a question, hey, can I use the animation packs in HitFilm? And the answer is yes, but you have to wash it through Blender. So let's do that. So here I am in Mixamo, and if I click on Browse Characters, I can see different characters. I think I will just search around, and let's go with Kajakin Rosales. I really like this model. That is a lovely model. And if I go to animations, you can see that I can just add in specific animations like the capoeira, and now she's doing the capoeira, right? And I can download that, etc., and so on, all right? But here's the thing. If you search a little bit, or if you look long enough, and I'm just going to search for pack, then you will see that there are packs of things, right? Like this breakdancing pack with 34 animations in it, right? Or this basic shooter pack, right? Or this magic spell pack, right? So what you do is you click on one of these packs, and then it shows you all of the animations that you can have that are in this one pack. And here she is dancing, breakdancing. She's doing all this breakdancing stuff, okay? So now all you have to do is just download this by clicking here. And again, you can select all of your choices and bring it into your computer. When you download it, it will make it into a zip file. And when you unzip it, then you'll see that you have all of these different files. Each one of these are a separate FBX animation file, along with, of course, the original T-pose file, which is just labeled the character, in this case, Kajakin G. Rosales. So what we're going to do is we're going to open up Blender. In Blender, we will click and delete the default cube, okay? And then we will say File, Import that original Rosales model, FBX, which is right here. And I will click Import the FBX. And there she is. And if you, I'm just going to open up the animation here a little bit. You can see that there is no animation for her, okay? So she's there. She has all of her, materials. Everything is ready to go. She's all decked out with her skeleton rig, and everything is here. Okay. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to right click in this and make a new collection. I don't have to do this. I'm just doing this to make this easier to differentiate between the two things that I'm doing. I'm going to go and turn off or just hide the collection one so that you can't see her. And while highlighting collection two, I'm going to import one of the animations. So let's see, File, Import, and again, an FBX. And let's just pick one. How about the very first one? Import it. And now you can see that there are the skeleton rig, and you can see that they're fully animated, right? And there it is. And you can see all of these keyframes down here, okay? But these are not all the keyframes. These are just some of the keyframes. So here's where you got to be careful. What you're going to do is there's a little arrow right here. You will click on that arrow, and it will bring out a sidebar that says summary. If I click on this drop down, now you can see, oh, look, here are the rest of these keyframes. So right from here, I'm going to, with my cursor in this box, I'm going to control C to copy those keyframes. Now I can go ahead and turn that off. I'm going to turn back on this collection, opening it up. I'm going to click on armature, and you can see that there are the same exact set of skeleton rigs here, but with different keyframes. So now if I have my cursor in this box and I say Control V, it will now paste those keyframes into this particular model's skeleton rig. And now you can see that she is breakdancing right there. So now all I have to do is export this, but I want to make sure that I have everything here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the selection box, and then I'm going to drag and make sure I have everything selected, file, export, and then export this as an FBX. Here it is, and I'm just going to leave this untitled so that I know which one it was and say export. Now I'm going to bring this into HitFilm. So I have a base scene set up here, and I'm going to go ahead and import a 3D model, and I will import the original Kajokin G. Rosales T-Pose model. And of course, I will need to, you can see that she's there, but not visible. So if I open her up and up the opacity, there she is. I would go ahead and do the rest of the deal, but for this tutorial, I won't worry about it. Click OK. This animation has no value, so I'm going to delete that. And I will just drag in the model. She's in her T-pose, and if you open it up under Models, you will find the Animations folder. So now I need to go ahead and import the 3D model animation, which for this tutorial I called Untitled. And now if I drag that into the animations, then you can see that she is fully animated there, right? And if I move her around and put the shadows on, it looks like this. And she is pretty much good to go for that particular animation that we brought in. It's very important that you do exactly the steps as I did them in Blender. It's real easy to mess it up and not get the correct animations. So if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. If you like this kind of thing, please give us a like, subscribe, share with your friends. And as always, thanks for watching.